I'm Barry Mitchell. What exactly is a citizen scientist? We'll find out when we visit Brooklyn's GenSpace Community Biolab. Ahead on Science Anew. GenSpace in Brooklyn is New York City's only grassroots community biolab, a sophisticated research facility open to the general public.
And you don't have to be a trained scientist to participate.
Do you know why the mushroom was invited to a lot of parties?
Why?
Because he's a fungi.
That's right, mushrooms. They're not just for pizza anymore. These Brooklyn Tech students are using the GenSpace lab to conduct research for the Urban Barcode Project, a citywide science competition in which participants collect local plants and insects and sequence the genetic information.
DNA barcoding is a way of identifying a species just by its DNA. And so the DNA has a unique spot on it, just like a barcode in a supermarket, that will tell you what organism it was.
What will you be barcoding today?
Button mushrooms, which is one of the most common fungi. These fungi perform a process called mycoremediation, which...
Whoa, what's that word, Matthew? Mycoremediation, where fungi filter out pollutants in soil and water. Extracting and comparing DNA enables us to identify other mushrooms that might perform the same cleansing function.
GenSpace provides a unique opportunity for students in New York City. I think it will prove to be an invaluable experience for the students that participate in the research.
It's going to give me experience with the equipment and technology and everything that they use in the field now.
And you said you do want to go into the sciences.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to be a marine biologist.
And since 2010, this funky old bank building on Flatbush Avenue has been home to scientific activity for all kinds of people.
Good science is fun. We definitely need a playground, if you will, where science could be carried out in a nurturing environment. And that's what GenSpace offers.
Dr. Oliver Medvedik and Dr. Ellen Jorgensen are molecular biologists and co-founders of nonprofit GenSpace.
One of the main missions of GenSpace is education, educational outreach. We have space for people to carry out their individual projects. We also offer a number of educational courses. It's much like a gym membership with more supervision.
Members pay $100 a month, and there's something for every citizen scientist.
A citizen scientist is anyone that's interested enough in science to actually get involved hands-on. It can range from anything to someone who reports what birds go to the bird feeder in their backyard, so we can track migration patterns of birds, to the people who come here and actually investigate their own genome and their own DNA.
And how about someone who plans to barcode all the plants and wildlife of the Alaskan tundra this summer?
Alaska is near and dear to my heart. I bought property there in 2008, and some friends of mine and I went up there and built a log cabin. There are lots of different organisms in Alaska that have not yet been DNA barcoded. It's very important to catalog all the organisms in order to be able to use this information in different studies. And this is an area where citizen science can really contribute big time, because it's a big job and we need everybody to help. There's a lot of different questions that might be answered. Are certain species changing their habitats, or are they changing what they eat? Are they changing their behavior because of global warming? Are species becoming extinct? But you have to have this baseline of having barcoded everything first.
If you'd like to know more about GenSpace and their various workshops and programs, go to
www.genspace.org.
And you're watching Science Anew.